I greet each of you in the wonderful, matchless name of Jesus Christ. The Apostle Paul penned words in his epistle to the church at Philippi in chapter 1, verse 4, that resonate with the current sentiments of my heart. I thank my God upon every remembrance of you, always in every prayer of mine, making requests for you all with joy. In the year 2000, I became the first assistant presiding bishop of our great church, serving with the late Bishop Gilbert Earl Patterson. Because Bishop Patterson and I were close in age, I resigned my mind that serving as the first assistant presiding bishop would be my final destination in the hierarchy of our great church. After the ascension of Bishop Patterson to the church triumphant in 2007, I became presiding bishop and chief apostle of the Church of God in Christ. I assumed this role with great joy, motivation, humility, and profound respect. In the past 13 years, I have attempted with the help of the Lord and many dedicated and loyal servants of God to serve the people of the Lord with dignity, love, kindness, righteousness, and utter commitment. I've endeavored to bathe each decision and every action in prayer and to be led of the Spirit of God on how best to lead His church. As I look back over the years that we have served together, I count it an absolute privilege and honor to have navigated this journey with you. What a journey it has been. If I may take a moment to highlight some of the accomplishments that we have attained together. We have completed the first comprehensive financial audit of the records of our church in more than 100 years. We've renovated most of the buildings on our headquarters campus, including the Lee Administration Building, the Mason Home, the main sanctuary and lower level of Mason Temple, the L.H. Ford Administration Building, and the Leela Mason Hall. Many of our downtown Memphis properties have also been restored. We made major renovations and upgrades to the Lexington facilities, including the addition of land parcels. We acquired additional properties around our headquarters campus, developed 77 apartment homes near our Mason campus, now known as Mason Homes, on 4th. We successfully moved the Holy Convocation to the 502,000 square foot America Center in St. Louis, Missouri from 2010 to 2019 with space for every aspect of our ministry. I could go on with the accomplishments that your prayers and support have helped bring to fruition over the past 13 years with God's divine favor. Suffice it all to say, God has been good to us. While 2020 has been trying, we serve a God who is able to do exceeding and abundantly above all that we can ask or think. As I reflect on 2020, I'm glad to report that I am in my 64th year of preaching, my 51st year of pastoring, my 35th year in the bishopric, and my 32nd year as a member of the General Board, and 13th year as presiding bishop and chief apostle. In addition, God has blessed me to see age 80, to be the husband of my wonderful wife, May, for more than 50 years, the proud father of Kimberly, Charles II, and Lawrence, and grandfather of 10 wonderful grandchildren. People of God, I have had a tremendous life, and I would not change one thing about it. Nevertheless, the coronavirus pandemic has allowed me more time to reflect on my life and the additional endeavors God would have me to carry through. I have had many great responsibilities over my lifetime, but the two that have always been forefront of my mind is my family and pastoring the West Angeles Church. God has blessed West Angeles to enter into the next stage of the Family Life Center building project, a $25 million addition that will attach to the West Angeles Cathedral. As a result of this major undertaking, I've made the decision not to seek re-election as a member of the General Board or as presiding bishop. I requested that the General Board grant me emeritus status at the time of the next in serving you. I pray that I have pleased him in all that I have attempted for the advancement of the great old Church of God in Christ, and ultimately for his kingdom. I remain committed to the success of our church and have pledged my support and assistance in a smooth transition so that the work of the Lord will seamlessly continue. I would be remiss if I did not take a moment to thank a few people at this time. First, to my secret weapon, Lady May, who I have had the pleasure of sharing most of the major accomplishments of my life. I cannot adequately express what Lady May's involvement in my ministry has meant beyond the fact that she makes everything better. My ability to be the presiding bishop and chief apostle, pastor of West Angeles, and other undertakings have been made because she has supported everything that I've done in my life. Thousands have been blessed each Saturday morning during the convocation with gems with Lady May, just as I've been blessed every day with those gems from Lady May. I could not would I want to, do this journey without her. Whenever someone says to me that I'm doing a great job, I quickly let them know that it's due to the fact that Lady May ensures that I'm able to serve God and his people because of her attention to detail and prayerful support. Honey, I love you and appreciate you so much for your love, support, and commitment to the work of the ministry and love of me. Next, to the Brotherhood, known as the General Board. I'm grateful to each of the members of the General Board for their prayers and support and commitment to the work of the Lord. They've lightened this load by accepting assignments and providing valuable assistance in the operations of the church. In addition, it has been my pleasure to work with each of them and to have developed relationships with each of them. I certainly want to thank God for the memory of Bishops Philip Aquila Brooks II, Nathaniel Wyoming Wells Jr., and Bishop Ted Thomas Sr., who all have gone on to the church triumphant this year. To the national elected and appointed leaders of our church, I believe we've been blessed to have an exceptional group of leaders who share in the management of our great church. Our various departments are second to none and are providing our members excellent service and leadership. I want to thank each of them for their commitment to the work of the ministry. Special thanks and appreciation is extended to the staff at headquarters and the presiding bishop's satellite office in Los Angeles for their exceptional dedication to doing an excellent job for the church each and every day. Their professionalism, dedication, and commitment to excellence has catapulted our church into providing outstanding service to the members we serve. And then finally, to every member of the Church of God in Christ, I say thank you. Thank you for prayerful support over the years. I have felt your prayers on my behalf. God has provided me the strength and fortitude necessary to serve as your presiding bishop and chief apostle. The love I have felt from seeing you at Holy Convocation and other conventions and even at jurisdictional events that I've attended over the years has been encouraging, overwhelmingly encouraging. I know that you will continue to keep me lifted in your prayer as I embark on this next journey, as I continue to pray for you and pray for our great church. Lady May and I love each of you beyond measure. We're grateful for your prayers and support over the years, and we look forward to God taking our great church to even higher heights in Christ Jesus, our Lord. And speaking of my wonderful wife, she has joined me today, and I would be remiss if I did not have her greet each of you to share the sentiments of her heart.
He made the moon to mark the seasons. The sun knows it's time for setting. And that's Psalms 104 and 19. Thank you, Bishop Blake. How precious you are. What a wonderful and exciting presentation. You are a great servant of God. Dearest saints of God, when I pause to consider the last 13 years serving as First Lady of the Church of God in Christ, I consider it my absolute joy. The joy in serving, teaching, worshiping, praising, fellowshipping, and growing with each one of you is a sentiment that I will never forget. I honor and praise God for the privilege and blessed opportunity and do not take a single moment for granted. The genuine love and respect that you have generously lent in support of my role as First Lady and wife of Presiding Bishop Charles E. Blake Sr. will always be etched in my heart. Thank you. While my foremost objective was to encourage and empower each one of you to be the best version of yourselves, please know that you too have encouraged and empowered me. I am encouraged to continue steadfast in the faith, knowing firsthand the impact of our collective influence as the Church of God in Christ. And I am empowered to be passionately me as I spend more time pouring into my wonderfully supportive family as well as my West Angeles church family. Each year, it gave me so much joy to create the Lady May registration bags for the convocation. And I sincerely pray that some of the literature that I was privileged to publish during my leadership tenure was a blessing to you. A Class Act 1 and Class Act 2, the Attitude Book, the Clutter Book Series, House and Mind Clutter, Your Attitude Determines Your Perception, Enjoying and Surviving as a Pastor's Wife. My goal was to simply share personal experiences as a determined Christian, as a woman of God, and as a pastor's wife for so many years. I pray that we can all commit to sharing our journeys as believers with others, and that we will take time to truly embrace the experiences of others. As the Bible says, an intelligent heart acquires knowledge, and the ear of the wise seeks knowledge. And that's Proverbs 18 and 15. Precious women of God, I would tremendously miss our annual gatherings of morning gems with Lady May on Saturday mornings during our convocation. Some of the very best highlights of my time with you occurred in these sessions. Even though there were 3,000 plus women, I also was richly blessed by our exchanges in such an intimate setting that was created. What an incredible gift from God. Saints of God, brothers and sisters, I hope that you can honestly sense the sentiment of my heart in my attempted expressions of gratitude for your love, support, and sheer benevolence toward me. I will certainly treasure my service to you as First Lady, as one of the high points of my life. Thank you for the very gift of your presence, both in person and in provision. I also would like to thank Bishop Blake for giving me the latitude and encouragement to produce and serve you in the way that God has directed me to do. Thank you. I also like to thank the fabulous West Angeles Church for allowing both Bishop and I to serve you. I ask that you continue to hold my close and beautiful family, Bishop Blake, whom I feel is one of the world's most awesome leaders, and me in prayer. May the Lord continue to bless and keep each of you. Forever, I extend my love to each of you, and God bless you. You know, Bishop, I am proud of the work that you have done for God and the people of the Church of God in Christ. Your commitment, your dedication, and love for the people of God has been nothing short of inspirational. We have all been blessed by your service.
Thank you, honey. Anything that I have accomplished, I have attained, has been because of the goodness of the Lord and the good thing that he gave me in you. Thank you for your unyielding love and support through the years. You made this journey wonderful. I have always been able to count on you for godly counsel and loving support our entire marriage. I love you. Beloved saints of God, from the very bottom of our hearts, it has truly been rewarding to serve all of you. We see our great church in the future, and we look much better than we do right now. God bless you, and may God continue to bless the grand old church of God in Christ.
Raise your hand and say,